introduce parsing. Now, whatever we have seen, that parsing can be three types. Most of the books, it's a top-down, bottom-up, top-down from the star symbol to you try to reach the string, that is top-down. Another is to bottom-up. So you try to reach to the star symbol, to the shift reduce method, and another is dynamic programming method, that is not within a syllabus. That is, we have started the talk CYK algorithm, early parser. Those are those basically try to combine to match to the star symbol or start from the star symbol. CYK is a bottom up parsing, and early parsing is another type of top down parsing, but it is a different, not it is left to, it is not scanning from left to right. So that is another type of parsing, and more of the natural language processing, we may have to go for this parsing, and there is the most use the dynamic programming. Okay. Now again, the top-down parsing, whatever we have found that first top-down parsing is you try by brute force method. So we try to start from S and try to reach, match the your lowermost symbol, brute force. If it is not match, you can go back again. That is, backtracking is allowed, and this is recursive descendant backtracking, but that takes inordinate time, that bit will hang, and it definitely ON. So we go for predictive parsing. Predictive parsing is definitely we can go reach ON time, but lot of restriction come in top down parsing, that is LL1 parsing. You don't have to go back, you don't have to trace back, but your grammar is a smaller set of grammar, that is no left recursion should be there. Even if left recursion you remove, it is not guaranteed. You have to calculate, you have to calculate fast and follow and all this. That is LL1 parsing, but it is a small set of grammar, LL1. But if you go for, say, if you can argue, say, if you go for LL2, will it take much more grammar? Yes, it take marginally better, but it is, the parsing table will be again huge. So LL1 is a practical limit of LL1 grammar. Then we come to the bottom-up parsing. Bottom-up parsing, the first thing is operator precedence grammar. Last class, we have discussed what is operator precedence grammar. Operator precedence variable, no two variables to be side by side. There must be operator within it, and no variable can go to epsilon like this. So that is a very easy shift reduce parsing, bottom-up parsing, because no two variables can occur in, side by side. The grammar is like E plus E or E star E. This expression grammar can be fitted into the operator precedence grammar, but not all. We'll check it. So operator precedence grammar is easiest bottom-up parsing by shift reduce method. Then we come to the general shift reduce parsing. The shift reduce parsing, whatever we have seen, that there are sometimes we can go to the star symbol, that there is some conflict between shift and reduce, because why we make, whenever the parser initially doesn't contain anything, and when you put the input first left to right, first put input into it, and we check the whether we will shift it, we take it another symbol for the input, or whatever is available on the stack, it looks like a handle. So handle means we can reduce it to the your leftmost variable, that is handle. Handle occurs only at the top of the stack, and there is, you have a, it is greedy algorithm doesn't follow here. If you find it, a particular terminal comes to a stack after dollar, then there is a rule matching that you can go to the variable immediately, like you can take it a variable to single terminal, but sometimes it will not do the trick. Maybe a star, shift is a better option. Then you put shift, then you go for another terminal there. Then it looks like if you have ID star ID, then that together is a handle, three terminals. Then you can replace, pop this and put a variable into this. So there is a conflict between shift and reduce. How to negotiate between shift to reduce? There are various ways we can go. One basic steps is LR0 item collection, and then another is SLR1 item collection, then LALR item collection and then the LR1 item collection. So first we try to understand what is LR0 item collection. Last we have started. So basically what is our concept is in the stack, we can think of a stack, we can always push and pop in pairs. So whenever you put a terminals into first terminal input, first left post terminal into it, then after this we put zero, like state zero. That's the first state zero. Then we compare with the state only, then the next input terminal. Then there is a table. The table is right now action table and go to table. What is action? There are four types of action. Either you shift it, or you can reduce it by a law, or you can accept it, or you can reject it. There are four actions. If you reduce it to a rule, then you have to go to section of that table. That state function will be there. You take out both, like zero and that particular terminal, then your particular state function, say it might be S1 or S2, will be there. So what is summary is that the stack is right now contains a stack state and the terminal or variable. So basically we are comparing with the stack state and the we are coming left to right. So that is it. The stack is right now consists of two items. The terminals are variables, or basically terminals in the stack state, and you can reduce it and pop it off. So that is, but you have to construct the LR0 item collection table. That is the first thing. So let's go for this. Yeah, this is the basically item collection. Whenever there is any rule, say we have a particular rule, see here, the first we put dot into it, and anything after dot will close our operation. Let's check this. We'll go for our item. This particular expression grammar, we'll do it in the port. This is the expression grammar. And it definitely you can see it cannot be done by LLOL parsing. This always check whatever we have learned, because the E is here, E is there, left recursion, T is here, it is left recursion. But it is unambiguous grammar. How can I say it is unambiguous grammar? If there is no T, if it is a E is there, no T, then it's the ambiguous grammar. Then you, because we want to give priority to the multiplication function, so we must compute the start function first. So that is we bring in one more variable t star f. If we get rid of t, if all t is replaced by e is here, then it is an ambiguous grammar. Maybe it is operator precedence grammar. Operator precedence, we disambiguity, we negotiate through the terminals weightage. That one day if I find time, I will do this. That is not much importance. But operator precedence is a very simple grammar. But this is a more general proper expression grammar. One thing is missing. You can add another rule, minus t, division t, but plus a star is good enough. So this is not LL1 grammar. You must appreciate, because e left recursion is there. So it is the expression grammar. This is the expression 4.1. It is I am taking from Aho's book. But this rule for item collection, I have to add one more rule above. It is e dash to e. So this is like you have remember in Chomsky's normal form. If whenever he was deducing, you have from any grammar to Chomsky's grammar, we take a fresh state S0, S0 to S. Remember that similar kind of thing in here also. We'll add one value grammar and rule here. E dash to e. Let's see it here. Yeah. So this is visible. I think it's visible. Okay. So this is our original grammar, and particular this string ID1 and ID2. I'll do it at board, and I'll do it at here also. Here you can appreciate still the problem. See here initial stack. It is not I am putting any state into it. What is the problem? I have to show it. How to avoid this problem? See initially stack should be dollar, and remember in the bottom up parsing the stack grows here and top down stack grows here. This is the bottom of stack and this is ID. You first shift it and you then so we can ID1 then another you see here start, so we can reduce it, yeah. We can first, but you can shift it also. Say we are reducing f.id, f, then whenever t is coming, I can reduce it by t to e, but I do not, I make a shift. There is a shift reduce conflict here. So whenever in the stack t is there and here the int star is there, I can do both. I can make t to e by rule number 2, or I can make a shift. I choose for shift. Why shift? So that is not deterministic, but I have both the path, but why you take the, but that is the correct path. So that problem can be solved by this LR0 item collection. That is the main problem. We will do it today. Yes. So here you see that this is our basic grammar rules. Yeah, then we add one more rule, that is we call a e dash to e. That is an extra, you can call it a augmented grammar. Yeah, it's augmented grammar, e dash to e. It will be clear to you, your augmented grammar. Then what we have done, we have to make an item collection. What is the item collection? Last day, like this is the first item, i0 is the initial state. Then first item is e dash to dot e. So dot presents that this is the first dot and there is something to there. And whenever I put dot e, then anything start with e, I have to, in the rule, this rule, now this is augmented grammar, I put it. So I put it e dash to e dot e dash t. Then because e, because here this rule is also that e to t, so I have to e to dot t because the t is here. So all, it should be closer operation, all closer operation. Then say I am dot is here, and say if, take example, I will see it here, first is id. So take the case of an id, because you know I'm parsing. We say if, because the id, so I go to a, I do it by if dot id. So here, see if the id comes, so this rule will be fine. And this rule is, I'll make it named i5. So first we go for, say if e comes, then we are at the accepted state. Then we go for another state i1, e dash to, now dot come after d, and e, and because it has to fire both rules, e dash to e dot d, because you know the rule is e dot, and here is also here another rule, e plus d. So there must be e dot t, and it is x. Then if it's an id, if it's a terminal comes, if t comes, then it will go to, say e dash, it will come to t, come to t, it is this rule, e to t dot. Okay, t dot comes, because, and you have another rule, because then you have t dot esther, because you have another rule t dot esther. So you take a collection of state, and this is the first state, and we have a i1, i2, i3, we number the state arbitrarily. It is no rule, but initial state we generate is state number i0, and if we see anything, it is a basically deterministic finite state automation. Yeah, it is a basically DFA. It is, you get the DFA, it is a, say, kind of equivalent to the accept state, and there is, you cannot have two transition with the same this thing. There is a collection, is a collection of this thing.
We are discussing today this grammar. This is the expression grammar. This expression grammar, this is these are rules. We added one extra e dash to e. This is augmented grammar. We'll come to this, why you've taken the augmented grammar. These are the rules. Expression grammar, definitely it is not a top, it is not a LLL grammar, because he is here, so it is left recursive, t is also left recursive, and also here it is unambiguous grammar, because we have taken the expression of t, t will give more importance to star, the multiplication will be computed first then plus, so it is unambiguous grammar, so it can be solved by bottom up parsing, by shift reduce parsing. So this is, we are item collection of LR0. What we have done, so we all have done augmented grammar, and then from augmented grammar we introduce a dot operator. The dot means the current state, so that if we are at dot, so we are yet to see E, and whenever dot at the end, so we have almost, we have shift all the symbols, now we have to reduce it. That is the concept. So we have put all the dot operator here. So for all the rules, and this E dash to dot E, then because dot E, then all related E rules, E to E dot T, E to dot T, and all these rules with dot operator, finally F dot IT. This we give a name I0 because say we get the initial state. Now we think that after this say E can come, not E dash, E, then when the E will come to hit, then dot will come here. So we will go to that state, say E dash to E. So this is, dot is at end, so we can reduce it. By this rule, by augmented rule, and if it is dot here, but here also these rules, dot is comes here, so this is also E dot T here, so we cannot reduce right now, we have to yet to get this one. So from E1, if we get a plus, then we can give E plus dot T. So this is the particular rule, this is the state where E, see, this is dot shift to here, so this is here, because dot is shift to here, so any operation beginning with T we have to express. So what are the operation? T star F, so these are all repeated, T star F, T to F, so because T to F, so T to dot F, and then F, because dot after F, F dot this and F dot this, so these are the canonical collections. We'll number the state after all this doing state, we'll number the state and we'll check any other state here. So we have to gone up to I6. Now we let's see, so take another rule. So I0, I get ID. Say ID, then what rule I go? I go to the I5. This is a final state. So because ID dot comes here, we can reduce it here. So we have ultimately one table, there will all have the state, and this is the final state, we cannot, this is the reduced state, and so this is ID. Then we go for this one we covered, then say these two have covered, then say dot T comes. If it T comes, we'll go to this route. T comes E dot T dot, so here you can also reduce. But it is not a final state, but yet we can have after T, this is also can have T dot star F. So this is not final state. Final state I have marked it by this. Then if the star comes, so we get T star dot F, and because of dot F, all the F related rules, F this and F this comes. Say here in I7, if the ID comes, again it can go back to the I5, which is the final state. So this way, the states, canonical set collections are made, and some of the states we found it like here, we say I5, I3, and I10, I11. These are all the states, these are final items there. Then all the rules will be reduced. There will be no outgoing edges. And certain state, there is a grouping also. We can see here in this particular I4 rule, how the I4 rule comes. Say here, after dot, this opening brace comes. So opening brace comes, this is opening brace dot E. So this is the first rule. Because dot E is there, all the related with E expressions come sit here. And now, see here, again here you see the dot, again opening brace come. Again, this will come. So this, there's a loop back. So this state with the opening brace, it can loop back. So this kind of IPOR, some typical states will be there. So ultimately, we just check our input string, say ID star ID, and how it will be. Say these are the our line, these are the stack. The initial stack is like this, and initial with dollar, and after this we have I0. I0 means the initial state, and we always compare initial state with the particular input symbol, and then we decide. We have a table, we'll draw the table there. We have a table there that we can deduce from here also. If we get a terminal, then we have to take some action, either shift or reduce, or accept or last reject. And if we get any other variable, then we have to go to another state. So the table should consist of all the number of states. Here, how many number of states after completion table we found it. Maximum we have 11 number of states. Yes, this 11 number of states will be there. So rows will be 11. The first will be the terminal that we have to take some action. The terminal action will be either shift or reduce or reject or accept. Accept will be the end. If whenever the at your stack the start symbol comes, and if any variable comes in the input, then you have to go to another state. So table should be all filled up with rows with the states, and vertical column will be the first vertical column with the terminals, then with the variables. That the variables only to go to state only. The state will be inputted here, and terminal we have to shift and state number. So this is it. So into the I0, the first ID it is here. The first ID we'll check it. That first ID it will be this one here. First ID it will LR. This is the LR parsing algorithm. This is basically bottom up parsing algorithm, and there are the table. Table, if we have a canonical LR0 collection, then it is LR0 parsing, and if it is a simple LR parsing, then the simple LR table. If it is a LALR table, then it's LALR parsing, but only the table portion will be the difficult. Table portion will be there. Table portion will change. The parsing algorithm, bottom up parsing, shift and reduce will be the same, and the input buffer will be your string. This is the stack. Stack, remember, stack contains your terminals or variables along with the state, and always state is compared with the input buffer, either input buffer terminals, and then we can go to either shift or reduce or accept or reject or go to another state. So this table will be different for LR0. We are not looking ahead anything beyond this. But whenever LR1 or LLR1, we will construct the table. We expecting something different terminal there. The number of states will be huge. Parsing table will be huge. But LR0, we are not looking ahead in the buffer. We are just looking. But we can look ahead only one. LR1, just look ahead only one. Here we have drawn this table. This is, we can call it LR0 table. LR0, the state numbers, we have calculated. We have first draw this table. We cannot get more than 11 number of states. So I0 to I21, 11, not more than, after all it will be looping. And there are some states like I3, I5, I10, I11 are final states. So that it's particularly deterministic final state automata. No other further going states. These are the accepting state, I3, I10, I11. Other states are canonical items and looping around. And then we have, this is the LR0 parsing table. And LR0 rows are basically the state number, I0 to I11. I0 is the initial state. And the first portion is the action. First portion is the action table. Action, you remember the only the terminals. Here the terminal, this is our rule, the terminals here, opening braces, closing braces, plus ID and star, is 5. This portion is called action, and what are the 4 kinds of action? Either shift, reduce, accept or reject. And the other portion of the table, whenever we getting the variables. What are the variables? E, T and F, not E dash. E dash we have taken as a help of the augmented grammar.
but here you don't need to have e dash, because e dash will never come to our, it will not hit any state. So let's try to understand the first row. See, this is I0. So this is whenever what are the things will come, we can have, we have the dot e. So if the e comes here, so it will come e dash to e dot, and then the another option will be, because the dot e, we have to include this also, e dot p plus t. This is the I1. So whenever this I0, only thing the I0, whenever we come the id here, here, then we will get it the this row. If it's the id, so for this, it will go for this id, is the, I go to I5 and reduce by I, this rule, left into id. So I5 comes here, I5 come I9, 10, 6, 4, I3, I5. This is the I5. It will reduce by this. This is the green color. This is the, let it color by green. Green. Then it will be understood that it is a final state, one of the reducing states. So there will be no outgoing states beyond that. This is I5. Same like I3. Okay. Then if it is opening braces come, I0, then it will come the, it's here, opening braces come here. So if the, then the opening brace dot E dot. So it will go to I4 and it is shift operation. This is the I4. See here, we have opening brace dot E and then all rules with the dot operator, it will come this. So everywhere we see most of the terminals we get the either shift, in two cases the reduce is here. Here it is reduce, whenever I0 we got it ID, the dot comes here and it goes to the rule number 5, state 5, and we reduce by this rule F to ID. And in other cases, say E comes, then it will go to I1. If it is come T, if it is come T, T it is comes to I2. See, if it is come T, say here, T dot, it is come, but we cannot reduce. See, even if dot comes here, yes, it can, we cannot reduce only on the getting the terminals, not on the value. We got the T dot, and for this, we got the T dot start the tables. Dot comes here also. So we have the both combined into I2. Then I2, if the star comes, see it goes to T star dot 5 like this, and other rules dot 5 will come here. Now take the examples of our input string ID star ID. So initially stack is dollar and I0. And then the, when the ID comes, so it will be shift condition. So see here I0, ID comes, so it will be I5 and reduce, I5 and reduce. So that is the thing you can have, this is stat only I5 comes. I showing in this, this is the, actually it should be, it is the stat top will be the 5.